In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with all of you. And brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate these mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. Lord Jesus, you raise us to new life. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. O God, by whom we are redeemed and receive adoption, look graciously upon your beloved sons and daughters, that those who believe in Christ may receive true freedom and an everlasting inheritance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, "You, son of man, I have appointed watchman for the house of Israel. When you hear me say anything, you shall warn them for me. If I tell the wicked, 'O wicked one, you shall surely die,' and you do not speak it out to dissuade the wicked from his way, the wicked shall die for his guilt, but I will hold you responsible for his death. But if you warn the wicked, trying to turn him from his way, and he refuses to turn from his way, he shall die for his guilt, but you shall save yourself." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, owe nothing to anyone except to love one another. For the one who loves another has fulfilled the law. The commandments, you shall not commit adultery, you shall not kill, you shall not steal, you shall not covet, and whatever other commandment there may be, are summed up in this saying, namely, you should love your neighbor as yourself. Love does no evil to the neighbor. Hence, love is the fulfillment of the law. The word of the Lord.
Reconciling the world to himself in Christ, and entrusting us the message of reconciliation. Alleluia, 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 alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "If your brother sins against you, go and tell him his fault between you and him alone. If he listens to you, you have won over your brother. If he does not listen, take one or two others along with you, so that every fact may be established on the testimony of two or three witnesses. If he refuses to listen to them, tell the church. If he refuses to listen even to the church, then treat him as you would a Gentile or a tax collector. Amen, amen, I say to you, whatever you bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. Again, amen, I say to you, if two of you agree on earth about anything for which they are to pray, it shall be granted to them by my heavenly Father. For where two or three are gathered together in my name, there am I in the midst of them." The Gospel of the Lord. I often hear, and I experience it myself, this desire from brothers and sister Christians, again within myself too, this desire to know Jesus, to actually hear his words, to come into encounter with him. And often there's kind of a wonder, like if only we were there, if only we could have seen his face and touched him and known him more deeply, how much easier it would to follow him. But in our gospel today, so beautifully, the Lord says, where two or three are gathered, there am I in the midst of them. Obviously different, not able to be touched, not able to be seen, but yet his presence is there. Do we believe it? Do we believe that truth, that reality? It means a lot for us, of course, as we are gathered here. We're gathered in his name. So that means that the Lord is here according to our gospel, according to Jesus's holy words. He is here. And his presence, when we recognize it, or when we choose to recognize it, requires a little bit of reverence. So we'll just take a brief moment to reverence Christ's presence here today. The one who knows us. The one who knows everything that's going on within us. He knows all of the distractedness in our minds. He knows the anger that may be present there. He knows the bitterness. I'm not saying we're all angry or bitter, but whatever it is that's going on in us, that he knows it. And sometimes those things serve as such a distraction because we are afraid that it's not right that we are here. But the Lord is here and we are here as we are. And he still loves us. He's still really present to us. And so we reverence it. Part of what we desire in coming to know Jesus is he draws us out of ourselves. His presence reminds us of who we really want to be, imitating him, following after him. And he is here encountering us as we are, doing just that, drawing us out of ourselves. And so we give in to his presence here today. Of course, we as Catholics also know that he's present in another way when we gather par excellence here as we gather at Mass, how he comes present to us at the Eucharist, feeding us, giving us his life. We know that that presence remains whenever we go and visit him in the Eucharist. Again, that presence is to feed us as he comes to us vulnerably. But there is the other way that's made very explicit in our gospel today, that he is present, that we can give into at almost any moment of our life. Whenever we are gathered in his name, that's whenever. In a particular way, it happens in a magnificent way when we're gathered here at Mass. But it can happen in our homes too, his presence. Perhaps when two spouses wake up in the morning and they pray and say, let's be in the Lord's presence today. Let's offer this day in Jesus' name. That means the Lord is present, always drawing you out of yourself. How different would our lives be if we knew the Lord is present always? How we would treat our children, how we would treat ourselves in our own weakness. The Lord's mercy is always present there to us. Perhaps it could happen, if you're willing, and in the workplace, if you know a fellow Christian, doesn't have to be Catholic, someone to stop and say, hey, let's offer this day in the Lord's name. The Lord there is present throughout the day. Perhaps even in another way, or there's so many other ways, at a meal, when perhaps there's frequently chaos during a meal, perhaps the spouses want to say, let's dedicate this meal to the Lord. The Lord is present, drawing us out, teaching us how to be in one another's presence. More closely to our gospel today, where Jesus gives us the Christian way of dealing with conflict, which is always claiming one another as our brother and sister first. What if we went to the person with whom we are in conflict and said, I need to have a conversation with you. Let's call upon the Lord's name first. Then Jesus is there, teaching both the person who is accusing and the person who is accused to show mercy, to open up in deeper humility. The Lord comes to bring his presence always. He's not as distant as we imagine. Of course, he's most profoundly here in the Eucharist. So we give into his presence this morning. Let's stand together and proclaim our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. With confidence in our Father, let us turn to him with our needs.
For the church, that we may reach out and assist our neighbors in reconciling with God and each other, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For leaders of nations, that they may grow in wisdom, seeking peaceful ways to resolve differences with others as they serve the people entrusted to them, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those given authority to uphold and enforce the law, that they may respect those they serve and apply the law with justice and compassion, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an end to the coronavirus and for all those affected by it, those who are sick, those who take care of the sick, those who have died, those who are dying alone, those who are fearful, those who have lost jobs, and those who are grieving, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For students attending school this fall in whatever manner, in person or at home and online, may they grow in wisdom and grace through the love of God. We pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the special intentions in our parish, for those who are sick and homebound, especially Carol Ansela Beher, George Perry, and Betty Zakowski, for those who have died, especially Nick Corpy, son of Lucy Corpy, and for Dylan Boyd, for whom this Holy Mass is being offered, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Loving God, grant us the will to listen for your voice and the grace to recognize it as we strive to follow you. Hear the prayers we offer and grant them according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
O God, who give us the gift of true prayer and of peace, graciously grant that through this offering we may do fitting homage to your divine majesty, and by partaking of the sacred mystery, we may be faithfully united in mind and heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory, as with one voice we acclaim: Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Bernard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For your spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
God is my shepherd. steps must wander. My spirit shall not fear. My spirit.
Let us pray. Grant that your faithful, O Lord, whom you have nourished and endow with life through the food of your word and heavenly sacrament, may so benefit from your beloved Son's great gifts, that we may merit an eternal share in his life, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. A couple of announcements for the week. This Monday, as we all know, is Labor Day. The parish office will be closed, and there will be no 9:15 a.m. Mass that morning. At the request of Pope Francis, we will have a collection basket this coming weekend for the Holy Land. Because COVID happened during our Easter season, we didn't have a public Good Friday service, which is when our normal Holy Land collection would have taken place. So this coming weekend, we'll have a collection for the Holy Land. Registration forms for religious education and the sacraments of confirmation, first reconciliation, and first Eucharist are available online on the parish website. Then if you or anyone you know might be interested in becoming Catholic, please contact the parish office as we're beginning to start the RCIA process. The first session will be on Wednesday, October 7th, and anyone is welcome to join. We'll have a little bit of a limit, so just let us know if you're planning on coming, but anyone is welcome to come, even if you just want to learn more about the faith. We continue to need help at our masses with ushering and cleaning. We're happy to announce that the age restriction to help with each of those is lifted. It's helpful if you could let us know if you would like to usher or to help after Mass. However, if you forget to check the box when you sign up for helping after Mass, we are always in need. So even today after Mass, if you're able to help out, we would love to have you help clean up with Mass. We're also encouraging everyone to sign up for Mass. I know I think everyone, just about everyone here signed up for Mass this morning. But I'd also like, it's going to be as particularly important as the numbers at Mass rise, and they are rising, which is beautiful, which is what I want to see. But priority is going to be given to those who register for Mass. It's also helpful for us if you can register for Mass before the weekend. It just helps us to plan beforehand. You're still welcome to come if you forget, but it helps us to plan if you sign up before the weekend. I'm not pointing fingers at anyone. Okay, that's it. So the Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace.
Lord.
gladness of heart and mind. May love be ours, Lord.